Hello friends, welcome to jQuery UI video tutorial series. In the previous video tutorials, we understood what is jQuery UI and why jQuery UI. We also downloaded the jQuery UI library to the default downloads location and we extracted it. We got a folder with the name jQuery-UI-1.12.1. In this video tutorial, I would like to discuss using jQuery UI library. We follow some simple steps. First of all, I am going to create one new folder with the name jQuery UI demos. I go to desktop, right click, say new folder. This folder is going to have the name jQuery UI demos. Within this folder, I am going to put all the jQuery UI demos that we are going to have in this video tutorial series. Next, I am going to create one folder with the name jQuery-UI within jQuery UI demos folder. So I go to desktop, open this folder, I right click, say new folder, control V. So this folder is going to have the name jQuery-UI. Within this folder, we are going to put the necessary folders and files of jQuery UI library. Next, copy paste the below mentioned files and folders from jQuery-UI-1.12.1 folder to jQuery-UI folder. As I told, we are going to copy paste external folder, images folder, jQuery-UI.min.css file and jQuery-UI.min.js file, which are the necessary folders and files from jQuery-UI-1.12.1 folder to jQuery-UI folder. So I go to the default download location. I open the jQuery-UI-1.12.1 folder. Within that we have the external folder, images folder, jQuery-UI.min.css file, jQuery-UI.min.js file. I click on external folder. I hold down the control key. Click on images folder, click on jQuery-UI.min.css file, click on jQuery-UI.min.js file. I press Ctrl C to copy them. I go to jQuery UI demos folder. I open the jQuery-UI folder. I press Ctrl V to paste them. You can see that we have pasted the necessary folders and files. External folder, images folder, CSS and JavaScript file. Within the external folder, we have another folder called as jQuery. Within the jQuery folder, we have jQuery.js file. Our jQuery UI library is dependent upon the jQuery library. So we should have this jQuery.js library within this folder. Next, in the images folder, we have some images which contain the favicons or icons used by the jQuery UI library. And jQuery-UI.min.css file contains the CSS styles based on the theme selected. By default, the theme is basic theme. And jQuery-UI.min.js file contains reusable functions that we can use. What we do next? Next, create and save a new HTML document with the name default.html within the jQuery UI demos. So I'm going to create one default.html file now. I go to start, say here notepad. I click on the notepad. You can see that the notepad got open. Here I'm going to write the basic HTML5 document structure code. We know that every HTML5 document is going to start with less than exclamation mark doc type HTML. By reading this line of code, browsers understand given HTML document is the HTML5 document. We know that every HTML document begins with opening HTML tag and ends with closing HTML tag. From here to here, it is considered as HTML document. And every HTML document is divided into two sections. One is a head section, another one is a body section. To indicate the head section, we write opening head tag and closing head tag. To indicate the body section, we write opening body tag and closing body tag. So this indicates the head section, this indicates the body section. In the opening HTML tag, we write lang equal to en. That indicates the language of this document is English. Within the head section, we write meta charset equal to UTF-8. This line of code indicates the character set of this document is Unicode Transformation Format 8, which is a character encoding. Then here I say title, closing title tag. Within that I write jQuery UI demos. Now I'm going to save this file. File, save as. I save the file in jQuery UI demos folder with the name default.html. Both sides I put double quotations. Click on the save button. I minimize the notepad, minimize the word. I click on jQuery UI demos folder. You can see that default.html is created. I right click on default.html, open with the Google Chrome. You can see that default.html is open in the Chrome. Title is set to jQuery UI demos. Next, we are going to link the necessary jQuery UI library, CSS and JavaScript files to the default.html document. So we need to link the jQuery-UI.min.css, jQuery.js file and jQuery-UI.min.js in the same order. So first I am going to link the jQuery UI min.css file to our default.html document. So I go to the head section. Here I say link href hyperlink reference. Here I am going to give the folder name first. So I copy this jQuery-UI folder name, paste here. Within that we have the jQuery-UI.min.css file. I copy the name and paste here .css. The relationship is style sheet. The type of content inside that file is text or CSS. Now we have linked the jQuery-UI.min.css file to our HTML document. Next we have to link the jQuery file. So to link the jQuery file, I am going to take help of script tag, opening script and closing script tag. It has an attribute called as src. To that we give a source path, right? So first of all, I go back to the jQuery UI demos folder. I select this jQuery-UI folder name, copy that, paste here. Within that we have the external folder. I'm going to copy the folder name and paste here. Within that we have the jQuery folder. I copy the name and paste here. Within that we have the jQuery JS file. I copy the file name and paste here .js. The type of content inside that file is text or JavaScript. Now we have linked the jQuery library. Next we have to link the jQuery UI library. So I'm going to paste the same code down here. Now I just put the jQuery-UI folder name, because within the jQuery UI folder we have jQuery-UI.min.js file. I copy the file name and paste here .js. Now we have linked the jQuery UI file also. Next, what we have to do? Next, we have to call the jQuery UI functions on HTML elements. First of all, I am going to create one div with an ID of date picker. In the body section, I am going to create one div with an ID of date picker and I say closing div tag. If I say file save, go to browser and refresh, you don't see any date picker there, because we need to convert this div to an actual date picker. How do we do that? We take help of jQuery and jQuery UI functions. So let's do that. Here I'm going to say opening script tag and closing script tag, and I say here type is equal to text or JavaScript. We know that jQuery as well as jQuery UI are JavaScript libraries, so we are going to write those codes within the opening script and closing script tag. First thing is I need to take help of jQuery function. So here I say jQuery function, or I can simply use the dollar sign. And in double quotations within the pair of parentheses, I say hash date picker. So we are telling, hey jQuery, locate any HTML element in this page if its ID is set to date picker. Here this div has an ID set date picker. So this div is going to be selected or located or targeted. On that div, we are going to call a function called as date picker, which is available inside the jQuery UI library. So when I call the date picker function, you see that this div is going to be converted to a date picker. Now I'm going to say Control S to save it. I go to browser and refresh. You see that a date picker created. Simple, right? And you can pick a date, you can change month, you can select the date. This is how you can use the jQuery UI library. I hope you guys have clearly understood the steps to follow to use the jQuery UI library. In upcoming video tutorials, we are going to understand jQuery UI in depth, step by step. I think for this video tutorial, this much is enough, friends. I suggest you people to try this. Try to create a date picker by yourself. For more benefits and be up to date, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and don't forget to like, comment and share these videos with others so that everyone will get benefited. Keep learning, keep coding, keep sharing. Thank you guys. Thank you very much. See you in the next tutorial.